number six of the evening is a kickboxing bout scheduled for three two-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Boca Raton, Florida. He weighed in at 164 pounds. This is Jose Murillo. His opponent across the cage is fighting out of the red corner. Coming to us from Enterprise, Florida. He weighed in also at 164 pounds. Dante Young.
MFCA presented by Mo Muscle Fighting Championship in association with the Space Coast Fighting Championship. We are live on Fight TV in the cage right now. Jose Murillo in the blue corner and in the red corner. Dante Young, both men, very game opponents. And we are looking forward to this matchup. Murillo out of Lima, Peru, by way of representing Boca Raton's American Top Team, Palm Beach. And both men open up with leg kicks, as you said in the beginning of the fight. And Jose Murillo called that he'll try to end this fight with leg kick TKOs.
A nice strike. I mean, this is a high-level matchup. I know that this is an amateur level, but this is a very high-level matchup. I'm watching Dante Young now, and he moves very well. And this is going to be a test. This is really going to be a test for the young Jose. Like I said, he is working those leg kicks. He is working those leg kicks, but they're not landing. He has a very experienced opponent. And like I said, when I talked to Dante backstage, he actually let me know that he never looked up his opponent once. He doesn't do that. He has enough experience that he feels that he can change his game plan to his opponent if necessary. And I thought that that was really amazing. Like I said, that's something that you can only do from years of experience. And, I mean, right now he is putting on a clinic. I mean, he is really working very hard, and he's given young Jose all that he can handle, who's very game, by the way. He is striking, but like I said, when sometimes just that level of experience, it really comes and plays into a factor. You have a young guy, 1-0, versus someone who has over 10 fights in kickboxing on their resume, as well as capoeira and Brazilian jiu-jitsu. So this is an awesome test for the young man, and we'll see.
Murillo taking this fight just on 2 weeks' notice. Right on the brink of a short notice acceptance, if you will call it, short notice.
Oh, what a nice head kick that landed. Maybe he's stunned, and he's got nice blitz, and he has gotten looking for the clinch from Dante Young.
Oh, and he's landing.
Yep. Dante Young has gotten his feet about him. But what a nice land from Jose.
Murillo staying elusive. He's trying to get out of the way of those big shots. Final moments of the first of three rounds.
Man, what nice body shots. What a great round. What a great first round to this kickboxing match. Man, all action. We're starting to see Dante Young. He spit his mouthpiece out. We'll see how that goes. No sitting down for Jose. For Jose, man, this is really exciting. Gets a little bit of water. Now, the second round is really going to be telling for who's going to win this fight. Like I said, young Jose responded very well to the blitz that Dante gave him. And we're going to see. Like I said,
absolutely.
This is the opportunity.
And both men with their own journeys to speak of. Murillo tonight, the young 22-year-old who has a lot to prove as a competitor. And then Dante Young, he has his own journey as well. Quite an incredible one. He has his own redemption story that you don't hear talked about as much. He actually got into some trouble about 10 years ago. He ended up in jail for almost 5 years. And look where he is now.
Wow.
He got out of jail, and as soon as he did, immediately got right back to training and being the martial artist that he is, turning his life around. And look at this redemption story. Look at this disciplined specimen of a human being. Unbelievable. And hats off to him for having such an amazing career and pushing forward. And Murillo has a very tough, grizzled veteran in front of him to prove himself
Absolutely.
To.
So we're really getting to see the best of both worlds, like I said. You get to see the up-and-coming, and then you get to see those people that are fighting for a lot. And they have a lot to fight for, and who's going to win? Like I said, is it the Young Bucks time, or is it the true? What a nice head kick from Murillo, and this is what I'm talking about. This is why you got to watch the second round, because they are both ready. They respect each other. They have some movement down. That leg kick is starting to land on, for Jose. I mean, this is really, really a great matchup.
Absolutely. And Jose, you have to really kind of give him some credit, and I don't want to take anything away from him or say that he's any less skilled, but across from him and Dante Young is a Muay Thai kickboxing instructor. I mean, he actually teaches Muay Thai, and his first Muay Thai tournament was about 5 years ago, so he's been around the block for quite some time doing this exact discipline. So I have to really give it up to Jose for being able to go and stand for three rounds, well, two so far, with the veteran that is Dante Young.
But do not sleep on Jose, because as I said earlier, mom and dad are both professional fighters. So he has been around for quite some time, and the competition and the level of people that he spars with are on Dante's level or better. Now, he has never taken a serious fight with someone on this level, and when we're watching him respond. His family definitely believes in him to become the next star of the family and to really follow in that bloodline that they've laid down for him. So this is a real opportunity. This is his destiny meeting him in the ring right now.
And as you can see, all the makings of a star in the making, and definitely able to hang with somebody like Dante Young. Dante getting the better of the exchanges still in both rounds. And Mario, of course, that second generation on two different fronts, mom and dad both being fighters, you can see that coming through here as the second round ends.
This is not the average 1-0 fighter versus a 10-year vet. Like I said, this is a great match, an absolutely amazing matchup. Both fighters are in it. Like I said, much, much better round in the second coming from Jose. I mean, I don't know. He landed several big head kicks and had Dante stunned. So we could be looking at
a 1-1. Yeah, we could definitely be looking at a 1-1 situation here.
I'm looking at the corner. They're very calm and relaxed on both sides. They're talking to him, letting him know. I mean, if you look at Jose, he looks very calm. Like you said, that's when you do your best work. Also, Dante looks calm, but he looks disciplined as if he's on with whatever, as if he's on a journey. You know, he looks like this is what he does in every fight. He just turns around, looks down, and gets the coaching while facing away from his opponent. That's what he does. And now he turns around and is back to work. So
no distractions during the break. It's a purposeful break in the corner.
Absolutely.
Leaves his opponent out of it.
Absolutely. And it looks like there's a bit of water on the floor. So we're going to get it wiped up real quick, clear. And we're going to finish this action. And this is going to be a great round. Like I said, this is the fight. The fight could be determined here in the third round. Neither opponent can feel confident that they're going to walk away and they can't coast. No one can coast.
No.
We need to see the best of each fighter right now. And I think we're going to see that.
Yeah, I would say the key word is a moment. You're going to have a moment in this third round and steal this round and hopefully come away with the third and final round. Here we go. Third and final round. Let's see. Scheduled for 2 minutes.
And Dante comes out quick, definitely understanding the need and the situation right here. It's 1-1. He came out and started controlling the fight. And this is what you got to do. This is the veteran experience coming in, playing into the role.
Grinding him out.
Keeping your back against off the cage, pushing your opponent up against the cage. Maybe he's not landing as much damage, but he's winning the round.
Absolutely. Controlling all of those instances where they're engaging, he's basically just bullying them up against the cage. And that will speak in volumes to the judges, as you said.
A very veteran move, like I said.
Well, there's one leg kick, but it's not going to be enough for a TKO.
No. Like I said, in that second round, he landed some good ones. And I see. I'm not sure. He landed one to Dante's left leg, and it seems to be – it might have gotten a little limp there. See that? You saw that? Those leg kicks are landing. Like I said, I can see a sustained effect here. At distance, Jose looks amazing. I mean, he's really controlling that distance, and Dante is giving him the blitz. Oh, lost the mouthpiece by Dante. That's that moment that we're talking about. That could be that big moment.
It could be, yeah, that's what you need. The visuals are everything.
And he doesn't want to come and put it back in. Like I said, he's fighting without it. Referee can stop it at any time, get it back to him. But he's walking him down, keeping his back. There you go. Now back to the veteran moves. But now we need to see a big moment from Dante, because we've seen that from Jose. we now at this point, after the big moments from Jose, the judges may not see that control. That's those leg kicks.
A lot of snap in those leg kicks. Oh, and he goes up high and lands.
That's the third head kick he's landed in this fight. Like I said, Jose is.
He may have run away with this third round.
That was amazing. What an
amazing
fight.
He may very well have gotten away with this third round.
And he's giving it to the crowd, and they both turned. They out here. Man, what an amazing fight. What an amazing fight for the crowd. Man, that's it, man. They did it. Veteran moves, Young Buck showing that heart and the tenacity and the control. I mean, you see everything that you want to see from Jose, and you see that discipline and everything that it means to Dante. So I'm really excited to see who wins. I think we may have our first split decision.
I mean, it's very possible.
I think we have our first split decision today. Who do you say won?
If we were going in to the third round tied, I'm gonna have to lean into Jose Murillo. I'm gonna have to give him the edge in the third round. But that all depends on if we were going into the third round 1-1. And I think that may vary judge card to judge card.
So let's see.
Well, we're gonna find out right now. Let's go to Jay Pinkham with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Your winner by unanimous decision, Blue Corner, Jose.
And look of surprise. And a pure look of surprise coming